police or whatever else. Yeah.
I want to go back to what we were talking about a few seconds right before the break there, and you were saying people have, you know, they'd rather have security than liberty. And I'm not bashing on Michael Dukes, by the way, but he basically put that in a nutshell last night. A lady called in and asked him how he could tear into Schaefer Cox all the time. And he said, hey, I like to go out to the movies. I like to take my wife out in the town. And I like to go out to eat. And Schaefer Cox was threatening that by standing up against the government. And that's how, I mean, and people regard Michael Dukes as a very patriotic person. And that's the measure, that's the model. If the more patriotic people are scared of anybody that stands up, and I'm not saying what Schaefer did was right, not his way of standing up, but standing up against the government, standing up for your rights, threatens our ability to go out to eat, then there's a problem.
Good point. Looks like we've got a call.
458-TALK is the number. We'll check out the phone lines. Good morning, caller. Who's this?
Yeah, this is Don.
Don, what's on your mind today?
A good example of the stuff that you guys are talking about is in one film that I've seen. It's been there for quite a while. The film called Barbed Wire with Pamela Anderson in it. And it's where, like, they have enclaves all over the world, the United States or whatever. And to get from one place to another, basically you had to have your eyes go through a retina scan, and then that way you could get on the plane. The planes were all run by the government, the airlines, and their SWAT teams and all that stuff at the airports. So you lost your freedom to move around and stuff. You lost your freedom to be safe and all that. Your town was basically closed up at night by, say, 8 o'clock. And so, you know, where does the loss of, when you get the security, where's the loss of the freedom and liberty that you had? So, I mean, it's a good example, something to look at and understand more why it's important to try to stand up to government.
Thanks for the call.
Yeah, it's look at the state of Texas. They passed a law where they were going to basically make it a misdemeanor for anybody from TSA to do what they're doing to their citizens, and the federal government said, you do that and we'll shut down all your airports. Now, if you look across the world, when we see other nations that do that, stuff like that, look at Syria, we look at Libya, any of those, what do we call those? We call them dictators and we call them tyrants.
Oppressors.
What's the difference here? I mean, basically, because we have democracy and we're spreading democracy all over, mob rule.
Don't you believe in democracy?
Let's play that clip. We got a little clip to, we're going to talk a little bit about democracy, but first we're going to let the good old gang at Charlie Brown give us a good view of what democracy really means.
If you guys want to vote, get your own ballots. Okay, gals, vote. Mark your ballots.
Good grief.
Okay, the ballots are marked. Marcy, tally the count.
Vote for guys outside, gals inside. Vote for guys outside, gals inside. Vote for guys outside, gals inside. And I know my vote is for guys outside and gals inside.
Great! A unanimous decision. Chuck, you guys pick up your junk and move out.
Hey, wait a minute. It's cold out there. Besides, we found this cabin, and we were here first.
Look here, you saw the vote. It was done legal and straight. Do you believe in democracy?
Well, sure, but...
Well, Chuck, this is a democratic vote, and it says you guys are out. All you guys, pick up and get. This cabin is off limits to you. Out, out, out.
Let that be a lesson to you. This is democracy in action right there. You know what? I think I mean, it's humorous, but the Peanuts gang, they get it exactly right on. That's exactly what democracy is.
It is. It's a perfect example. So simplistic for a five-year-old to understand. You don't have liberty. You have mob rule. Well, this is our cabin, so we voted you out. Out, out, out. Pack your junk and go.
Mm-hmm. That happened somewhere in the world once already. A perfect example.
Mm-hmm.
In China. They went and they took all the farms from the big wealthy farmers and they distributed them among the people. And then later on they went back and took them from all the people and appropriated them to the government. And the people that got those things all whined and screamed that they were having them taken away from them. China's more closer to a democracy than it is to a communist state.
Nowadays, they're not a whole lot different than us, I wouldn't think. I mean, except we have the facade that we're living in liberty daily, but we don't really, do we?
I don't think so. You ready to go back to the phones?
Yeah.
458 Talk the number. Good morning, caller. Who's this?
Hey, John here.
Hey, John, what's on your mind?
John.
How's it going, gentlemen?
Hey, John, good to hear from you.
Hey, yeah. You know, it's like you say, you know, and I'll quote Joe Stalin, it's not those who cast the votes who count, but those who count them. So he had it figured out, and it seems the guys these days do too. And also, you know, your reference to China, you know, when socialism loses its luster, it's polished by the treads of tanks. But having said that, what do you guys think about that recent story with the Department of Education having a SWAT team and smashing down people's doors and dragging them out onto their lawn and handcuffing them? Any comments? I'll hang up and let you discuss that.
All right.
With three children under the age of 10 present the whole time? I think what John's talking about is the Department of Education. Someone, apparently this man's wife, was behind on her...
student loans.
Student loans. So the Department of Education turned it over to a SWAT team. The SWAT team busted down the door, grabbed the guy. Apparently the wife was estranged, hadn't seen her for a period of time. Drug him outside in front of his little kids, smashed his face into a cop car, and proceeded to search for the wife. So the Department of Education now apparently has police powers in the United States of America. But you can't do anything about it because the Indiana Supreme Court said that you cannot keep law enforcement from coming into your home for whatever reason.
Even if they don't have a warrant or even if they don't have any proof that they are police.
Correct. And also the United States Supreme Court said the police can come into your home for any reason anyway.
They don't need to even have probable cause. All they need to have is a badge.
Exactly. Which goes back to, do we have liberties inherent to us by a creator, or do we have quote-unquote rights given to us by a Bill of Rights and the Constitution?
You know, what led our founders, Josh, and I think that history will bear me out on this, what led our founders to make that break with England was not some kind of political fervor. It was a religious belief that their rulers were making a mockery of what God intended man to be.
Absolutely.
You know, and if you look at where we're at right now as a country, do you know many? I mean, you may know some people, but in terms of the vast majority of Americans do not have that kind of connection to a higher power in their life. That the highest power for most Americans is either the government or their entertainment. And I think, in fact, in most cases, it's the entertainment that's the higher power. As long as the government keeps them entertained with their circuses, give them plenty of bread, then people aren't going to revolt.
The government does a good job making sure that we're entertained, and they do a good job disseminating information out to keep us from looking at what's really going on.
See if we can squeeze in one more call here before the Fox News at the bottom of the hour. Good morning, caller. Who's this?
Morning, gentlemen. This is Tim.
Tim, what's on your mind?
I was listening to Michael Duke last night, and I think he's a big boy. He can stick up, but I don't think the context in his statement is quite the same as what you're making it sound. But on another item, what is your guys' opinion of this the requirement to have people collecting welfare tested for drugs?
Good question.
I suppose as long as it doesn't interfere with me going out in the town or going to see a movie, who cares?
I'm not really for welfare in the first place, but I mean, it's not necessarily a bad thing, I guess, but you have to go, the basic problem in the first place is we have a government giving out welfare.
The way it seems to me is if you're going to go home with whoever brought you to the dance, you know, if you're going to the government to get your free money in the first place, then you may as well submit to the government rules for drug tests. We're coming up on the Fox News here at the bottom of the hour. A reminder, of course, to check out Beaver Sports today. where they've got that special sale going on from 11 to 4. We'll be right back with more of Patriots Lament right after the Fox News here on KFAR. We
this
are
is
local talk radio.
KFAR, the home of Fox News.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. The Casey Anthony murder trial resumes Monday. This morning, the state's expert witness on insects took the stand.
The entomologist telling the jury that these blowflies very commonly live and lay their eggs on decomposing animals. That's what led him to believe that there was evidence of a dead body in the trunk of Casey Anthony's car.
Fox's Phil Keating. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton calling the death of a terror leader in Somalia a significant blow to Al-Qaeda.
Fazil Abdullah Muhammad joined Al-Qaeda in 1991. He allegedly planned the U.S. Embassy truck bombings in Nairobi and Dar es Salaam in 1998, which killed 223 people. It catapulted him to America's top 10 most wanted list.
Jane Dougal with Fox Sister Network Sky News. And the DNC chair is now calling on Democratic Congressman Anthony Weiner to step down nearly a week after he admitted sending lewd photos of himself to women. Fox News, we report, you decide.
We report it, you respond to it. Fairbanks is listening. This is Local Talk Radio, 660 AM.
All aboard!
Welcome back to Patriots Lament. Some would say that we've gotten on board the crazy train because we believe that the government is not the source of our liberties, but that something higher is. And, I find myself wondering at this point, maybe I am crazy to think that somehow America might ever regain what we had at our founding. In fact, I'm becoming more and more convinced that it won't. What do you think of that? I mean, do you think that... I gave you a story right over there about the EPA and how there are a number of studies that have been done here. And what's the project there on that the studies? And the EPA doesn't like the results that they're getting?
For the proposed pipeline that would carry oil from Western Canada to the Texas Gulf?
Right. There's this other this pipeline that is going to go through Canada to take oil from the oil sands there in Alberta to take it down to refiners in Texas. And they've spent hundreds of millions of dollars. They've done study after study after study. And because they haven't come up with results that show it to be bad, basically because the results of these tests keep on coming up and saying, yeah, it'd be fine. They should go ahead and build it. The EPA says, nope, not enough studies have been done yet. And they refuse to grant the permits. And I just, you know, it seems like the same kind of thing that we get with the recount, like what happened in Florida with the recount of those votes back in the year 2000, or even this last election here in Alaska with the hand counts, where certain candidates got hand-counted ballots and the other ones only got machine count, that those who want to stay in power are going to keep things that way, and liberties be damned.
Well, Steve, I don't think we need to really get more oil anyway. We just need to put a cap on oil companies, how much they can charge us for it. We don't need a free market. We don't need to...
Or, you know, what we could do is we could subsidize the oil and just make it cheaper for the rest of us by just paying the oil companies.
Or we could throw the EPA out and let them do their job and watch the prices drop dramatically because there's not hundreds of billions of dollars spent in proving that there's oil there and that they can get it out safely.
You know, see, now that's my line of thinking right there, Josh, is that any of these agencies that are not, I mean, okay, I don't really care if an agency was created by a vote of Congress or by an act of the president or by anything else. Any group of people that is not an elected group of people that's making rules because they can, to me, I don't think stands up to constitutional muster. But